Good evening and welcome to Beaudry Field for tonight's contest between the Draket Middies and the Concord-Carlisle Patriots. Alongside of my co-host, George Dristoliaris, I am Ronnie Perrin. Tonight's contest, Johnny, George, is very important to both teams.
Yes.
Draket right now stands at in eighth in the playoff picture, where Concord-Carlisle stands at ninth. So pretty much the winner of this game probably is going to assure themselves a playoff berth.
Correct.
You've seen Concord-Carlisle in the past play.
Yeah, I actually coached against them for three summers.
What do you expect from this team then?
They're a high-paced, wide-open offense that they'll try to push the perimeter with wide plays and then come back and try to get you with a trap with a strong running back.
Okay, so last week we saw a tale of two teams with Draket. 203 yards from David Choate, who, again, was probably the offensive player of the week. This week, I think a big, strong running game again. I know Concord-Carlisle pushes the ball with two different running backs. Is it going to be imperative for Draket to seal up the run, okay, and not concentrate so much on the pass? Because I'm not sure if Concord-Carlisle is a big passing team or not, but I do know they have two big, bruising running backs.
Well, what it is we're going to have conditions may call for, you know, keeping the ball between the tackles. So I envision both teams to try to run the ball, and has been the key for Draket is to play that break, don't bend defense. You know, when the ball goes in the red zone, toughen up, limit them to 3 points maybe or none, and then work your own offense. You know, Levasseur out of the quarterback position is another running back. So between him and David Choate in the backfield, they should be able to at least keep Concord-Carlisle off balance.
Well, earlier today we spoke with the coach, and this is what he had to say.
Coach, two wins in a row. What things have you seen from your team that have impressed you the most?
Just more consistency. We've been very very good on defense. Kids have been running to the ball. It's been 11 guys to the tackle all the time. The consistency on defense has propelled us. And then this past Friday night, we were able to sustain some drives, continue some drives with getting first downs on big third down plays. I think we had three or four first downs on fourth down plays. So just through the program, just overall consistency.
Okay, Coach, it was going to be senior night tonight. I think senior night's been canceled. But the question I was going to ask you was, how emotional is it for you to see your seniors moving on? And what have you hoped that they gained from their experience here at Draket?
It's tough. It's tough to watch each class go on, you know, regardless of your win record or how successful or unsuccessful your program is. You've worked with most of these kids for 4 years, so it's hard to get to see any of them leave the program. We've always had an open door policy to keep them back. I guess the biggest things I hope that they learn is just values of life from the game of football, and we try to instill that through what we teach in the game of football.
All right, so right now you're ranked eighth in the playoff picture, and from what they're saying, again, from what I read, you're probably going to need a win tonight to secure a playoff spot. There can be some other scenarios that may happen, even regardless of win or loss. Your opponent tonight's Concord-Carlisle. What have you seen on film that concerns you about this team, and what do you think it's going to take for you guys to come up with a victory today?
We're going to have to play consistent, just like we did last week. We're going to have to play all three aspects of the football game. Concord's coming in with the same situation. They sit at ninth in their playoff slot. A win and they're in. We're in the same situation. A win, we're in. We don't want to have other things dictate where we go. We don't want to worry about what other teams do and hope that this happens and that happens. We want to make sure that we control what we got to do. And, you know, and Concord-Carlisle is doing the same thing. As for what they have, they're a physical football team, very characteristic of what the last two teams we played. And they have two dynamic backs, number 2 and number 24, both with great breakaway speed.
Okay, good luck tonight. Keep it going.
Thank you, sir.
Good.
Thank you.
So it's going to be the Draket Middies against the Concord-Carlisle Patriots. Two teams with similar styles. Should be a very good game tonight. Let's bring it down live to the field right now. Good evening and welcome to a soggy Beaudry Field here in Draket, Massachusetts. Alongside of my co-host, George Dristoliaris, I am Ronnie Perrin. Tonight, the Drake and Middies face the Concord-Carlisle Patriots for what conceivably will be a playoff berth, as Drake is now ranked eighth in the playoff picture, and Concord-Carlisle is now ranked ninth. So again, it's probably going to be a win, and you're in. George, you've been watching a little bit of what happened. You were actually a little bit of a Nostradamus a little bit earlier. You had said that you thought that the conditions of the field at some point in time were going to dictate what happens in this game, and I think you're spot on.
I think absolutely, and it's basically a lot of it's going to be running back technique, where they hold the ball to their body so that they can possess it. Because one bobble, the ball's going to squirt out of there. We could have a whole lot of turnovers tonight. It'll make for an exciting game. The kids will love playing in this. This is a lot of fun for them. Not so much for those of us who are watching the game, but as an athlete, this is fun. They're gonna enjoy this.
Okay, George, let me ask you this, though. I want you to put your coaching hat on, okay? You know, generally speaking, both of these teams are a hard-nosed running team, okay? And before we get to that, let me just do this. We have the game time current conditions. Temperature 66 with a dew point of 65. The wind is east-southeast at 5, gusting to 10 miles an hour. And we're looking at the Doppler radar right now, and we can tell you that there's a large swath of rain that's coming north to us. And so chances are this is the best you're going to see. So, again, game time conditions, a lot of rain. So, George, getting back to what we had talked about, you know, we know that both teams are both running teams. They're both pounding the ball. They like to pound the ball. Let me ask you a question. Do you think that changes the philosophy of these two teams? Do you think maybe you'll see more passing because of the field conditions?
Well, you know, you could see, you know, the passing all depends on the wind. But if the wind calms down a little bit, passing is actually easier on these type of conditions from the offensive point standpoint, because the offensive player knows where he's going. The defensive player doesn't know where the offensive player is going. A lot of slips and falls, and you know, could open up the field. A prime example: a few years ago, the Patriots played. I forget who it was. It'll come to me while I'm talking. And they put up a 50-point. We put 50 points on them. I think it was Tennessee Titans.
Yeah, I think you're right.
Because it was in the snow, and right. Brady knew where his guys were, and there was a. They just murdered them.
Okay, so they're at midfield right now for the coin toss, and I just want to give a recognition to the referees. Tonight the referee is Fred Sim. The umpire is Luigi Fusco. Back judge, Jeff Fario. The field judge is Rick Emerson. Head linesman, Ed Jarrett. And the timekeeper is Bill Graves. So again, at midfield right now are the captains for both sides, awaiting the coin toss.
Looks like Concord-Carlisle won the toss.
Drake's won the toss, and they're going to defer to the second half, which means that Concord-Carlisle will receive the opening kickoff. And Drake is going to be coming right to left on your television screen. So sit back and relax right now, because I got to tell you, two teams with similar styles, I think this was going to be a good one, George.
Well, here we go. And it looks like the kids, I mean, they normally jump in a whole group before the game, but it looks like both teams were excited to get this thing going in this. And Drake is kicking with the wind, so that may dissuade Concord-Carlisle from putting the ball up early. But a lot of things can happen with an odd-shaped ball and bad conditions.
Well, we'll see what happens just from the opening kickoff. I think we're going to kind of get a sense of what's going to happen as these both teams run down the field in this soggy field. The center of the field right now is just literally a swamp. So it's going to be interesting to see how the kids respond to this type of field condition. So again, as we said, Drakett won the toss, and they have elected to kick off and defer to the second half.
Ladies and gentlemen, please stand and remove your caps for the playing of tonight's Star Spangled Banner. Oh,
once again, welcome back to soggy Beaudry Field for tonight's game between the Drake Middies and the Concord-Carlisle Patriots. The coin toss has been done, and Drake won the coin toss and has elected to defer to the second half, which means they'll be kicking off to Concord-Carlisle. George, as we said earlier, and you were Nostradamus again earlier about the field conditions, it's actually starting, looks like it's starting to just to lighten up just a little bit, but the forecast isn't very good for the rest of the night. Again, you know, two teams that like to pound the ball, is that what we can expect for both of these teams, or do we think maybe they'll be a little more passive?
Well, I think Concord-Carlisle, I mean, they have two very good running backs, but they don't look like they're pounders in there. They look like they're speed guys. And Drakett has Lavassa, who is definitely a pounder. And so the footing may be an issue on for these quick-cutting backs on Concord-Carlisle, so you may see a bunch of slip and falls as far as they're concerned. So, I mean, anything can happen. It's tough to predict in these conditions, but at least it's not cold, right? And at least it's not snow, and we can see the yard marker. So I think we're good. And, Ronnie, we are inside.
That's
right?
True. We're nice and warm. I'm not too bad
right
now.
No, this is fine.
I'm not too bad at all. Okay, ready to kick off and start the game. Back to receive for Concord-Carlisle is number two. And we have a little bit of a pooch punt up to the middle. They're just going to jump on the ball. Kind of a smart move by Concord-Carlisle there just to get the ball going and so they can start off fresh without any incidents happening. So Concord-Carlisle, after the kickoff, is going to take over. First and 10 on their own 40-yard line. So, again.
And look at Ron. Look at where their line will be lined up. Drake seems to have some grass on their side, and it looks like Concord-Carlisle is in the mud to start
the game off.
And they're in
so
tight formation.
Concord-Carlisle is coming out in a tight formation, which actually a pro set formation.
Correct.
So here we go. Hand up straight up the middle. And a tackle by a host of Drakett players.
After a short game.
Look like number two, Jalen Farquharson for Concord-Carlisle on the carry for a gain of about 2 yards. So it's going to bring up a second down and 8.
Ronnie,
for Concord-Carlisle.
One thing I noticed on that, Concord-Carlisle's offensive line had trouble digging in and pushing out.
Sure. I think we're going to see that most of the night.
But they'll be better at pass protection because Drakett won't get that push.
Same formation, second down and 8. Again, handoff towards the right side. And again, Drakett all over the play by a host of players. This time the running back was number 24, Sam Randall for Concord-Carlisle. And here's the replay. Going to skip the replay? Okay. Yeah. All right, no replay on that one. We'll get the replay thing going. But again, that was for about a gain of 1, so it's going to make it 3rd and 7 for Concord-Carlisle on their own 43-yard line. Again, they're coming out in a pro set formation with a wing to the left. Under center is number 14, Jay Eagley. Eagley has the ball, tosses the ball to the left side, and that's going nowhere as Drakett has snuffed that out. For a loss, Sam Randall was the running back on the play. That's going to be a loss of about 5 yards, which is going to bring up 4th down and 11. And here's the replay on that play again, George.
Yep.
As you can see, just a straight pitch. And, you know, it almost looks like he's very tiptoey on it,
and
you know, because of this. So.
His lead blocker fell down. I think that's why.
Okay, so, again, 4th and 11. Concord-Carlisle is in punt formation.
It's
hard to see who's back with the rain and the numbers, so back to receive. But Concord-Carlisle gets the snap. The punter runs a little bit and punts the ball towards the middle of the field, and there's a fair catch, and it's fair caught at around the 30-yard line for Drakett, and that's where Drakett's going to take over. First and 10 on their own 30-yard line. So, Concord-Carlisle comes out in their first offensive possession. They go 3 and out. Drakett's defense very stout on the run. And now it's their chance to come back and see what they can do in this soggy field.
Let's see what Drakett can do.
Yep.
I think Drakett might have a little advantage here. They do have bigger backs. I don't think this is necessarily a speed thing. I think this is more of good traction and be able to plow along.
Okay, so Drakett comes out of their huddle. And they're coming with a shotgun formation with Lavassa as the quarterback. Handoff straight up the middle to David Choate. Choate gets a good chunk of yards up the middle over the right side of the line, up for about 5 or 6 yards. So a good run, good first run for David Choate.
Almost 8 yards.
Again, last week's play of the week, 203 yards against North Andover.
He's on. He's hot right now.
So, again, a gain of about close to 7 yards, and it's going to bring up 2nd down and 3 for Drakett. Ball's going to be spotted on their own 37-yard line. Coming out of the huddle again, Lavassa in the shotgun formation with Alan French to his right and David Choate in the back formation. The fumble on the play. It looks like they had a problem with that exchange, George.
I think the quarterback bobbled it when he got it, and he tried to hand it off while it was bobbling. I think it's a matter of the conditions.
Yeah, so that's going to be a loss. It's going to bring up third down and 9 for the Middies on their own 31-yard line. So, again, I think the weather conditions obviously are playing a havoc a little bit early, George, here, and I think what's going to end up happening is as this rain continues, it's going to be a question of who's going to make the bigger mistakes, you know, for this game.
We could see a battle of punts for field position now.
All right, so Drake comes out of the huddle, and they're down at their own 31-yard line. Third down and 9. Lavasso in the shotgun again. He's got French to his left and Choate in the running back eye position. Lavasso fakes the handoff to Choate and runs over to the left side
for a
short gain on the keeper. And he gained about 2 or 3 yards, but not nearly enough for the first down. That's going to bring up fourth down for Drake on their own 34-yard line. So, again, two possessions, George, and pretty much the same results for both teams.
Well, but I think Drake had an initial good play and it was in good position, but they fumbled.
So. All right, so back to punt. Looks like Lavassa is back to punt. And at around the 35-yard line, two receivers for Concord-Carlisle. So here's the punt. It looks like it's a good punt. And number 27 fumbled the ball. The ball's back. And the ball goes out of bounds. Out of bounds. Number 27.
Fumble punt. Goes
was
out of bounds.
Alex Hamill fumbled the ball, and the ball went behind him, and it ended up going out of bounds at about the 22-yard line of Concord-Carlisle. So, again, the conditions.
We've seen two possessions. We've already seen two fumbles.
Two fumbles, right. And I don't think it's going to decrease anytime, George, with these conditions.
No.
So, again, Concord-Carlisle is going to take over first and 10 on their own 22-yard line. 7:04 to go here in the first quarter. No score here at Beaudry Field. Concord-Carlisle in a pro set. Handoff is to number 2, Jalen Farquharson, over the right side for a minimal gain.
Yeah,
maybe a gain of 1, but again, Drake gets right there defensively.
Stop for no
and
gain.
So,
it'll
again,
be second and 10.
Second down and maybe 10. We'll call it 9.
The Concord-Carlisle offensive line is getting no push. You may try to see any type of counters or some traps coming up because what they're doing now isn't working.
Okay, second down and we'll call it 9 for Concord-Carlisle. Pro set again. Handoff straight up the middle. But again, very little gain. Very minimal gain. A host of midi tacklers. Was led by number 5, Devin Lambert.
They did try a trap.
Here's the replay on this again, George.
They pulled the left guard, as you can see.
Yeah.
And they want to cut behind him.
Right.
But
nothing there.
Nothing was there. The Drake defensive line defeated that trap.
Yeah. So minimal game again. It's going to be third down and about 8 for Concord-Carlisle on their own 24-yard line. Again, they're coming out into a pro set with one wide receiver to the left. We got a pitch. And again, nothing. There's nothing there for them at all. Drake gets all over this. Drake is stuffing out any type of run that Concord-Carlisle has to throw at them. Drake has just been snuffing it out. So that's going to be a no gain in the play. Actually, it's going to bring up a loss of about 2 or 3 yards. And
Drake is far more physical right now, and they seem to be enjoying the conditions. They seem like they're having some fun.
Fourth down for Concord-Carlisle and 12 on their own 20-yard line.
Now you can see, Ronnie.
Back in punt formation.
When Drake had started, they booted from their 30. Now we're down to the 20.
Yeah, so it's gradually in a field position game. So back to punt. Here's the snap. It's a high snap. It goes behind, and we have a fumble. He picks the ball up. The punter picks the ball up and kicks the ball. Nice job just to get the ball off. The ball's going to roll over midfield, and it's going to stop and be down by Concord-Carlisle at the midi 45-yard line. So that was almost tragedy again for Concord-Carlisle.
Well, if you've noticed this, the kid punting for Concord-Carlisle, he runs to his right before he's trying
to get out of the slop is what he's trying to do.
Well, no, he was doing that before the game. That was how he was practicing. It's almost like an Australian rule.
Okay, so you can see the play again here, George. Again,
right.
A little bit of a high snap.
It goes through his hands.
And it ends up going through his hands. And now he gets the ball, and he does a nice job. Number 27, Alex Hamill, does a nice job just to get the ball off. So it is first down and 10 for the Middies at their own 45-yard line. Shotgun snap, handoff up the middle for a good gain. Looks like David Choate Choate just grinding away up the middle in the swappy field. Gains about 9.5 yards on the play.
So
another
David
good,
ran,
good someone, run.
Someone's got a hot hand, huh?
Nine on the play.
He's kept up from where he left off last week.
For the Middies.
So it's going to bring up second down and less than 1 yard for the Middies on the Concord-Carlisle side of the field at about their own at about Concord-Carlisle's 46-yard line. Shotgun formation again for Lavassa. And we have a flag on the play.
The right.
Let's see what the call is. We have an illegal procedure against Drakett.
The right guard moved.
A little bit of a dispute on that by Coach Rivers. Coach Rivers isn't happy about that call.
Well, I don't think he's happy with the call.
It's a false start.
His guy moved. Whether somebody came across the neutral zone was another thing. I didn't see that.
Second and six for
the Middies
right
at their own 48-yard line. Yep. Shotgun formation again for Lavassa. Choate is in the set. Gets the ball. Bounces the ball outside. Choate's bouncing the ball outside. Down the left-hand sideline. And out of bounds. He's run out of bounds. Run out of bounds by number 27, Alex Hamill. So another big gain for Choate. And as you said, he's just left off from last week. And we have a timeout called on the field. I think it's a timeout called by Drakett on the field. So after that run, Drakett is going to be set up pretty well with first and 10 on the Concord-Carlisle 28-yard line. So again, as you said earlier, on the play again, watch this play here, George, where Choate initially does get to the outside, but he just bounces it right to the outside. And again, a nice play by number 27, Alex Hamill, to save the touchdown.
Yeah, he's got good instincts. Yeah. You know, there was nothing there. He bounced it outside. The safety for Concord-Carlisle actually made the play down the field, but he should have been up closer to anticipate that. He was kind of looking at the pile.
So with 4:05 left to go here in the first quarter and a soggy, soggy field here at Beaudry Field, there is no score. Drakett on the move. And so far, Drakett really has controlled both sides of the ball. David Choate is showing again how he is a premier back here and has driven the ball down to the Concord-Carlisle 28, where it's first and 10, shotgun formation. Lavassa's going to take the direct snap, just going to run right up the middle with the ball, and he's going to get probably a gain of about 3 yards. So a gain of three for Mike Lavassa, which is going to bring up about second down and seven.
Ronnie, if you notice, their formation is almost like a power eye, and I think they're doing that because of the conditions.
So again, after the three-yard run, it's second down and seven on the Concord-Carlisle 25-yard line. Lavassa, again, back in the shotgun formation, takes a direct snap, hands the ball off to Choate, who runs to the right side, and again, bouncing the ball outside, but this time is gang-tackled by a host of Concord-Carlisle Patriot players, led by number 31, Robert Doherty. So a short gain there, but still enough where it's a manageable third down. And again, in this position, I'm saying it's going to be at least a two-down situation.
It's definitely two downs.
So again, it's going to bring up third down and about a long five, maybe 5 yards for Drakett on the Concord-Carlisle 23-yard line. And, George, I'm going to tell you, as the game goes on, it's going to be tougher and tougher to figure out where they are. But right now we got a beat on it, and it's third down and five. So Lavassa, again, is back in the shotgun formation as David Choate to his left. Couple of tight end formation. Fake the handoff straight up the middle. Lavassa's going to run. Here comes Lavassa down for the touchdown. Mike Lavassa on the keeper. Went straight up the middle for the Drakett Mini touchdown.
Well, you know, Ronnie, once he got through the first level, there wasn't anybody in that backfield that was going to
take
him down.
No, that was the heat.
Right up
the middle. Big hole up the middle by the big man. Here's the replay of the game, George. Look at the hole he had here. Look at the big man up front in the trenches doing what they're supposed to do in this muddy field. Look at that hole. Right up the middle.
And look at
there were a couple of guys that had an opportunity, but Lavassa is just way too strong for both of those players. So, again, with that touchdown, with 2:41 in the first quarter, the Drakett Middies have jumped on top 6-0.
You know, Ronnie, this is a huge extra
number
point coming
Michael
up, by the way.
With a 23-yard touchdown and run.
In these conditions, you can't take this for granted. Nice little wind behind him. That's not 10 miles an hour.
So I think Coach Rivers is right now pondering actually whether he wants to go for one or go for two. In these conditions, I guess, you know, You know, I don't know. Maybe going for two would be the play. Would be the smart play. So there's a discussion going on between the referee and Coach Rivers. But now the teams are going to line up right now again. 2:41 into the first quarter, and Drake has drawn first blood against Concord-Carlisle and leads 6-0.
Unsportsmanlike conduct penalty on Concord-Carlisle.
So we have an unsportsmanlike conduct, which will probably be assessed
on the kickoff.
So for the extra point try for the Middies, number 34, Alan French. Oh, I'm sorry, not Alan French. Number 34 kicks the ball up. And the kick is good.
So,
Kyle Durkin, number 34, with the extra point, makes the score.
The
Drake at Middies 7. And Concord-Carlisle Patriots, no score.
Your Drake at Middies 7.
Now, if they mark this off on the kickoff, which I think they will, Drake kicks off from their 45. Wouldn't you think an onside kick would be in order now?
Why not? That might be a good call.
Get it back and push another one in.
Might be a good call. The way the defense has started off early enough, it might be a good call to do that right now. A little element of surprise. So, again, Drake it started at their own 45-yard line and marched the ball down in about six plays, George say. So, 55-yard drive by the Drake it Middies. And it's resulted in a 23-yard touchdown run by number 10, Mike Lavassa. 2:41 to go here in the first quarter. After the assessment of the penalty, it's going to bring the ball on the Concord-Carlisle side of the field at the 45-yard line. So, George, I think you might have something.
Onside kick. You don't get it. What do they start at the 35?
The other option again is to try to keep it as deep as you can. And the way the defense has been playing, that field position would come back into play for Drake as well. So, number 34, Kyle Durkin, to kick off. Back to receive is number 2, Jalen Farquharson for Concord-Carlisle. The kick is a pooch kick over to the left side. It goes through.
The ball's open.
It goes through right. Number 16's legs, number 16 being Max Trinkle. And
kickoff is down.
He does recover the ball again, but deep again in Concord-Carlisle territory. Probably
line.
About the 13-yard lines. That's where Concord-Carlisle is going to take over, first and 10.
And they've had trouble moving the ball. I mean, if Draker can hold here and even push him back a little bit, they could be getting the ball on their side of the field
sure.
again.
So again, it seems again the weather conditions, Draker is actually handling the weather conditions as well as can be expected, and Concord-Carlisle so far has nothing but trouble. So it's going to lead to first and 10 for Concord-Carlisle on their own 13-yard line. Again, they're in the pro set formation. Number 14, Jack Eagley, rolls out to his left and is going to look for somebody, but there's nothing there, and Draken again is all over him for a loss.
On the scramble, taken down.
Number 24, Nick Carter on defense, stayed back, and that was an option play. It looks like they were going to try to throw the ball out of there,
yeah.
And Carter didn't bite, and he stayed with the receiver, and it forced the Concord-Carlisle player to hang onto the ball.
And as a result, it's going to be a loss of 3, which is going to bring up second down and 13 for Concord-Carlisle at their own 10-yard line, and again, they're just not taking well to these conditions right now. Again, pro set formation again for Concord-Carlisle. Straight up the gut again is number 2, Jalen Farquharson, for a very minimal gain again as Drake is really, really pounding.
Well, you know, Ronnie, what
defensively.
I'm wondering the last few plays here. I don't know this, by the way. I wonder if Concord-Carlisle has a turf field that they practice on. And, you know, playing on grass and mud
possibility.
Might not be, you know.
So, again, after that play, it is going to gain about 3. It's going to be about third down and 10 on the 13-yard line for Concord-Carlisle. Again, pro set formation. Fake the handoff. And we got a fumble. Fumble on the ball. Fumble
touchdown.
On the play. And it's a touchdown for Draken.
The
Draken Middies have recovered the fumble in the end zone for a touchdown. Wow. Again, we see the replay on this. You're going to see, I think, from the vantage point that we had, the quarterback faked the handoff up the middle and started to roll a little bit. And I don't know if it was a Drake player that
fumble
popped the ball out.
But 10,
Mike Lavassa is the one that was in on the play, and he's the one that picked up the touchdown. Here it is again on replay. And again, as you can see, the quarterback's going to go back, fake the handoff, And his own player, it looks like his own player, ran into him and caused the fumble. The ball went into the end zone. Drakeit Lavasso recovers the fumble. And after the extra point, which is good, with 1:19 to go in the first quarter, the Drakeit Middies have gone up 14-0 against the Concord-Carlisle Patriots.
You know, you saw the down was 3rd and 10. And you fake, you expose the ball and fake a handoff. Why? No one's buying that.
Right. Not when you're not running. And it's a good point. Great point.
And somebody came in and stripped him, and Lavasso, who was on the rush all the time and is always around the ball, recovered it.
So in a very, very meaningful game for both teams, George, pretty much win and you're in the playoffs. The Drakeit Middies have come out firing in all cylinders.
Yes, they have. And you know.
All right, so there's going to be a delay in the game right now. There's going to be a delay in the game as there is lightning in the area. So again, with 1:19 to go in the second quarter, there's going to be a halt to the game as there is lightning in the area. So again, 14-0 Drakeit. You're watching the Drakeit Middies football here on Drakeit Access TV. We'll take a timeout now while there is lightning in the area.
Dirk is set to kick off from his 40. Squid kick to about the 45. Pounced on by the Concord-Carlisle Patriots. First and 10 from the 44 with 1:17 to go. Trevor Hoffman split wide left. Back to pass. Throw to Hoffman. He catches it at about the 42-yard line of the Middies. First and 10 for the Patriots.
Concord-Carlisle pass complete over the middle. Results of the play is a first down.
Handoff to number 24, stopped after a short gain by a cluster of middies.
Run up the middle, stop for a short gain. It'll be second down and 8 for Concord-Carlisle.
Second and 7 from the 40. Play comes in from the sidelines. And out goes wide. He falls down for about a loss. Let's see where they spot it.
And off to the Jaylen right side.
Farquharson
tripped up.
Fell down.
Short loss on the play. It'll bring up the third down for Concord-Carlisle.
Loses about 1.5.
And that will be the end of the first quarter here at Beaudry Field. Your score after one. Concord-Carlisle, 0. Your Drakeit Middies, 14.
Easter Day under center. Split backs. Steps back to pass, throws to number 27. Alex Hamill, who gets a large gain there. He's inside the 30, perhaps to the 27 and the 28.
Pass complete to number 27, Alex Hamill. The result of the play is a Concord-Carlisle first down.
We have a timeout, apparently by Concord-Carlisle. 22nd timeout.
And the timeout is taken by the offense.
sweep. He cuts it inside. Defense collapses on him about the 25. Gain of about 3.
Run to the right side. Stop for a short gain. It'll bring up second down for Concord-Carlisle.
Second and 8 from the 25. Easter Day under center. Short handoff to Jacqueline Farquharson. Maybe gets to the 20, 21.
Run by Conker Carlisle. Need a few yards on the play. It'll bring up third down. And about 4.
Third and 3 from the 20. 9:42 on the clock. In the second quarter. Randall bounces it outside. Pushed out of bounds.
Run to the right side. Pushed out of bounds.
Looks like to be about the 11. Gain of 9.
It'll be first and 10 for Concord-Carlisle from the 11-yard line.
Looks to be Randall again up the middle, gain of about 2 or 3. We'll see where they spot the ball.
Run up the middle, short gain on the play. It'll bring up second down.
Looks to be a gain of about 3 to the 8-yard line. Second and 7 from the 8. 8:57 and counting. Receiver split wide left. Handoff inside to Randall again. He chugs through the Drake defense to about the 5-yard line. Gain of another 2.
Carlisle run. Short gain on the play.
Looks to be 3rd and 5.
It'll bring up 3rd down and 5 for Concord-Carlisle.
And the call is a touchdown by Jacqueline Farquharson. Gets around the left end and touches the pylon. 14-6 middies. 7:56 remaining in the second quarter.
It's good. And your score with 7 minutes and 56 seconds remaining in the second quarter. Carlisle 7, your Drake and Middies 14.
42 back to kick, set to kick. Squibb kicks it to the short side of the field. Meadies pounce on it at about the 35-yard line, where they'll take over first and 10 with 7:54 to go in the quarter.
At the 35-yard line, Drake it will start first and 10.
Lavasseur in the shotgun. Hands off, up the middle.
Run by number 31, David Choate.
David Choate for about three on the play.
It'll bring up second down for the Middies.
Second and seven from the 38. Choate takes, brings him out of the huddle. Remains in the shotgun, with two backs set close to him. Looks to be Choate again. Short gain.
Run by Choate, stopped at the line for no gain. That'll bring up third down for the Middies.
Third and seven from the 38. 7:02 on the clock and counting. Nick Carter set out wide for the near side. Lavasseur takes it himself, gets the first down and a little more. He looks to be out to be about midfield to the 50. Tucks it under, rolls left, and keeps on going.
The result of the play is a Drake it first down.
Gains 12 on that play. First and 10 from the 50. 6:36 on the clock. Ball handed off up the middle, little off tackle there. Gets one, maybe two.
Number 31, David Choate on the carry.
Choate the workhorse.
Three. Call it two, it'll be second down and eight for the Middies.
Lavasseur keeps it again, gets one before he's taken down by a host of Patriot tacklers.
Short gain. It'll bring up third down for the Middies.
Should be third and seven now from the 47. Ball set on the near hash. Third and seven from the 47. Lavasseur looks to keep it. Now he pitches it wide. And Choate takes it to about the 42-yard line, maybe the 41. He'll be short of the first down.
To the right side.
Looks to be spotted at the 42. Gain of five. Have a fourth and two.
For the Middies.
Coach Rivers talking it over with Lavasseur. He gets it a little more. He's still on his feet. He's pumping for
more yardage.
He carries a couple of tackles inside the 30, inside the 25, to about the 24.
Plows ahead. Result of the play is a Drake it first down.
Gain of 18 on the play.
Lavasseur with the 18-yard run. It'll be first and 10 for the Middies from the 24.
Come on! 31 takes it wide. They spin him around. Doesn't look like he gets anything. Loss of about maybe one or two.
David Choate with the carry brought down. It'll bring up second down for the middie.
They spot him back at about the 26. Loss of two on the play. High snap. Lovisser keeps it himself. He's pumping for more. He may get back to the original line of scrimmage, which was the 24.
Number 10, Michael Lavasser on the keeper. Short game. The player ring up third down for the middies.
Third and 10, 3:06 to go in the first half. Toss to Choate wide. Good block out in front of him. He cuts back a little. He's inside the 20.
Looks to be
about
to the
15. Is that enough for a first down?
Brought down just shy of the first down.
No, gain of about 9.
It'll be 4th and 1 for the middies.
No doubt Drake is going for it. Looks like Concord-Carlisle is calling a timeout with 2:12 to go in the first half. 14-7 middies.
By the defense.
Middies come to the line. Choate remains in the shotgun. Pardon me. Lavasser comes to the shotgun. Trying to get Drake to jump. When we do have a false start penalty against the middies, three linebackers came up
before the snap
to the line,
it'll be a false start,
forcing the lineman to jump. That'll be a loss of 5. So 4th and 1 from the 15 is now 4th and 6 from the 20. Lavasser up the middle. He's going to be, no, maybe not. It looked like he was going to be stopped a little short of that, but.
Lavasser on the keeper.
Lavasser keeps it.
The first down.
Gets it to about the 16-yard line, maybe.
It'll be Concord-Carlisle's ball, 1st and 10. From the 17-yard line.
Hand out wide. Looks like Randall. Nope, that's Farquharson.
Back onto Carlisle. Stopped after a short gain. It'll be 2nd down and 7 for Concord-Carlisle.
Putting the ball on the 20-yard line. Gain of about 4, it appears. Second and six from the 20. Nice hit there by Drake. It looks to be a loss of about one or two.
Carlisle stopped by number 10, Michael Lavasser.
Lavasser on the tackle. They're
bringing up third down for Concord-Carlisle.
Gain of nothing, apparently. Not a loss. Third and six from the 20. Thank you to Mrs. Fortress for collecting my roster. Tom White on the field with 1:18 to go in the first half. Defense and offense talking about it. Third and six from the 20, chasing 7 points for the Concord-Carlisle Patriots. They've remained on the ground throughout the evening, not trying a pass yet. Maybe this is the time. Rolls out right, looks, throws it deep into single coverage to number 27. Incomplete.
Downfield is incomplete.
And Alex Hamill could not quite catch up with that pass. Fourth and six from the 20. 1:12 to go in the first half. And a rugby-style kick down the far sideline. Looks like it'll be down at about the 49 of Drakett, where Drakett will take over first and 10 with 59 seconds to remain in the first half.
Is down at the 49-yard line. And Drakett will take over first and 10.
Lavasseur keeps it, looks down, pitches it wide to Choate. He's got the corner. Oh, he runs over one or two tacklers there.
Lavasseur with the pitch to number 31, David Choate. To the right
ball
side.
Looks to be on the 43-yard line. Gain of 8 yards for Drake.
Gain of about eight. It'll be second and two.
Oh, fumble pitch recovered by Concord-Carlisle at the 43.
And Concord-Carlisle
number 77
recovered.
Comes away with the ball. That's Ben Linder.
After the fumble, it'll be Concord-Carlisle's ball, first and 10.
That's some middies misfortune.
From the 44-yard line.
Hey, 30 seconds to go before half. First and 10, 43-yard line for the Concord-Carlisle Patriots. Halfback option, 7 to a wide open number 27 Hamill, who stumbles, but he catches the ball, brings it down to the 10.
Concord-Carlisle pass downfield.
Correction, that pass is number 13, Trevor Hoffman.
13, Trevor Hoffman. Result of the play is a Concord-Carlisle first down. It'll be first and goal from the 10-yard line.
First and 10, clock running inside 10 seconds. Hand off to number two. He's going to take it into the... No, he's not! Stop at the one as time expires. 14-7 going into the half, Drake at Middies.
And that will end the first half. Your score after two quarters here at Beaudry Field. Concord-Carlisle 7. Your Drake at Middies 14.
We're back live at Beaudry Field on for Saturday Night Football. Coming out of the half, Drake leads 14-7 over Concord-Carlisle and will receive the second half kickoff. Drake will defend the track side of the field in the second half, or at least in the third quarter. And we're waiting for Concord-Carlisle to take its position on the high school side of the field and kick off. Number 42 to kick off. His name unknown since he's not on the active roster. Two back for the Middies to receive at about their 16-yard line. Neither team has kicked away all game long, which is in day two, by the way, as we were lightninged out last evening. Now a much drier field. Whistle for play, and we're off and running. Squib kick. Drake takes it at about the 44-yard line, it appears. Maybe the 43.
The kickoff is down at the 43-yard line. Drake will start the second half.
Number 18,
first and 10.
Ryan Talbot downs
the
ball.
From the 44.
From the second line of defense. .10:59 on the clock. Levasseur takes it, looks wide. No, he holds on to the ball. He cuts it back upside. Made it to the 49. Let's see where they mark him. Yes, the 49-yard line of Concord-Carlisle. Gain of about seven. Second and three.
Seven on the play. It'll bring up second down and three for the Middies.
Shotgun snap, hands off, looks like to 31, Choate, back to the line of scrimmage.
31, David Choate on the carry. Taken down, it'll be third down.
Nope, no gain on that play.
And three.
Third and three. Drake needs to regain some of that momentum they had in the first quarter and get this game moving along. Two split near side, one split far side. High snap. Choke gets cut down after maybe one by number 16 for Concord-Carlisle.
Number 31, David Choate on the carry. Stop for no gain. It'll bring up fourth down for the Middies.
Sounds like the Middies will punt from midfield with a steady wind pushing left to right. Two set back for Concord-Carlisle at about the 20-yard line. Punt block is on. He gets it away. Inside the 15. Nope, kicks back to the 16-yard line. Sorry,
Michael
Mike.
Michael Lavasser's punt. Downed at the 16-yard line. And Concord-Carlisle.
9 minutes to go in the third quarter.
We'll have the ball first and 10.
Two split back. Barquerson takes the ball, cuts it up. Oh, he's met by three middies on that play. After a short gain.
Stopped after a short gain. It'll bring up second down and seven.
They're marking him at the 19, gain of three.
Concord-Carlisle.
Second and seven from the 19. 8:36 remaining in the third quarter. Quarterback late to the party, getting the play from the sidelines. Carlisle splits two out to the near side, two in the backfield, along with the quarterback. He steps back to pass. He throws to number 27, Hamill, where he's met by two middies at about the 24-yard line.
Carlisle pass complete to number 27, Alex Hamill. Taken down, shy of the first down. It'll bring up third down for Concord-Carlisle.
Third and two, it appears, from the 24-yard line. It appears to be Randall. He breaks a couple of tackles. He's still on his feet. Out to about the 37, 38-yard line.
Handoff to number 24, Sam Randall. Taken down, but the result of the play is a Concord-Carlisle first down.
First and 10 from the 37. 7, 12, and counting. Barkerson to the left side, cuts it back. He's breaking away. O'Connell looks to be the...
Run by number 7.
Stop by number 44 of the middies.
Taken down, but not after another Concord-Carlisle first down.
Ball at the 24-yard line. Gain of 39 on the play. First and 10, Patriots. Single back set. 24, Randall takes it. He's met by a middie after a gain of about four.
Run by Concord-Carlisle up the middle. By number 24, Sam Randall, taken down after a short gain. It'll bring up second down.
Correction, make that a gain of three. It looks to be like the ball spotted on the 21. Second and seven. Looks to be a wing T. Offense for Concord-Carlisle here. Barkwhiteside cuts it back. Oh, he's met by a host of middies in the middle, and they're pushing him back. Let's see where they spot this ball. Do they give him the line of scrimmage or not? Officials conferring. Looks to be a loss of one on the play. Bringing up third and 8 from the 22.
The flag on the play is an illegal shift. On the offense.
And a late flag on the play, illegal shift by the Patriots. Brings the ball back out to the 26, maybe 27-yard line.
And we will replay second down.
So it's second and 12. Ball on the 26, 27-yard line. Looks another flag. Looks to be another illegal
flag
shift. No, false start. My bad.
And it's a false start on the offense. That'll back him up 5 more yards.
Drake clearly needed this momentum change. So now it's second and 17 from the 31-yard line. 5:25 remains in the third quarter here at Beaudry Field. Barkas takes it wide left. Minis are chasing. They cut him out. Maybe about the 25.
And that'll bring up third down for Concord-Carlisle.
Correction, the 26. Give him 5 yards on the play. It's still third and 12. Both teams need this game to need a victory in this game to make the MIAA playoffs. Ball standing at 3-3 coming into this evening. Drop back to pass. He throws it back the other way. Oh, he's got it. Touchdown, Concord-Carlisle.
Pass complete to the left side to number 27, Alex Hamill. And he is in for the Concord-Carlisle touchdown.
Kick is no good. Minis retain the 14-13 lead with 4:49 to go in the third quarter.
With 4 minutes and 49 seconds remaining in the third quarter. Concord-Carlisle 13, your Drake and Minis 14.
Coming back to live action, 4:49 to go, 14-13 Minis. Number 42 for Concord-Carlisle to kick off. In a heavy wind, we have yet to see a single ball kicked away. So the second line of defense is perhaps the Minis' best chance to recover this kick. yet another squib kick. Meany's fallen at about the 37-yard line, it appears.
At the 37-yard line, Drake it will start first and 10.
4:48 to go. Meany's offense jogs out to the line. Play called from the sidelines. Labasser back in shotgun. Looks to be choked to his left. His right, correction. Looks right. Holds the ball. Gets the corner. Gets across midfield to about the 49, where he's hit hard by a host of Concord-Carlisle Patriots. And we have a Patriot down on the side.
First down.
Might have gotten caught in the scrum there. That's the defensive tackle for the number 27, Hamill, was the injured Patriot. He's up and walking across the sideline with the trainer.
Let's go, offense!
So 4:38 to go in the third quarter, 14-13 middies. Ball on the 49-yard line. Gain of 14. But the Meanies have first and 10. For those of you wondering, Concord-Carlisle is ranked 7th in Division II North. The Meanies ranked 8th in Division 2A North. Both at 3-3, both needing a win for the playoffs. Labasser takes the snap, hands it off to Choate, who gets around the corner, inside the 42 to about the 37-yard line is where they marked him out. Gain of 12.
First down.
Another first down for the Meanies.
Timeout is taken by the defense.
4:06 to go in the third quarter.
Ladies and gentlemen, pull out your 50-50 raffle tickets. The winning 50-50 number tonight is 131995. Once again, the winning 50-50 raffle ticket, 131995. The winner can claim their prize at the Snack Shack.
So again, let's rehash the playoff scenarios here. Drake at 3-3, Concord-Carlisle 3-3. Both need a victory in this game to make their respective divisional playoff. In Division 2 North, where Concord-Carlisle resides, Waltham, Somerville, Concord-Carlisle, Medford, Belmont, all 3-3. All needing victories this weekend to move on. Snap to Labasser. Choate with the ball, goes left, gets about, I don't know, 3, maybe 4 yards.
David Choate with the run to the left side. Gain of about 4 on the play to bring up second down.
for the Middies.
Second and six from the 34. 3:37 to go on the clock. Levasseur keeps the ball. He gets around the end, maybe 1 yard. Continues to chug those lights. They get that. Oh, we have a late flag. Probably a personal foul that late.
And the flag comes in.
Trying to sort it out by the officials there. 24, Nick Carter over to get the play. And yes, that was personal foul against the Concord-Carlisle Patriots. Coach Mike Robichaud not happy about that call. He's halfway out on the field talking to his players.
After the penalty, it'll be first and 10 for the Middies from the 18-yard line.
Chote and Levasseur back deep. Looks to be
number 31, David Chote.
Chote
with the
on
carry.
The carry.
Taken down, and that'll bring up second down for
Loss
the Middies.
Loss of about a yard.
Here we go, Middies!
Bringing up second and 11 from the 19-yard line. Middies come out of the huddle. Thanks to Levasseur. Levasseur fakes, looks to throw, double coverage, out of bounds to number
Levasseur
seven.
To the right side.
Tyler Mayhew.
And that'll bring up third down.
Good play, a little too long to develop. 2:22 to go in the third quarter. Levasseur takes the snap, rolls left. He's got the corner. He's got the first down inside the 10 to the 5.
Runs to the left side. Taken down just shy of the goal line, but the result of the play is a Drake it first down.
They're marking it at the 1. We've got another Concord-Carlisle Patriot down on the field. No, we have 2 actually. Waiting for the trainers to get out there and take a look. Ball spotted at the 1, gain of 18 for the Middies. 2:13 remaining in the third quarter. 14-13 Middies. This is a well-fought, hard-fought battle. Middies coming to the line after talking to Coach Rivers. The injured Patriots
It'll
off
first
the field.
And goal for the Middies from the 1 yard line.
Ball in the far hash. Levasseur keeps the ball, powers into the end zone.
And
touchdown, Middies.
Up the middle. And he's into the end zone for a Drake it touchdown.
1:55 to go in the third quarter. 13 middies. 20 to 13 middies. And the kick is good.
And it's good. And your score with 1 minute and 55 seconds remaining.
Kyle Durkin puts the middies up 21 to 13. 1:55 to go in the third quarter.
Your middies 21.
What a response by the middies. Durkin to kick off. Only one back deep for the Patriots. Expecting a squib kick. And they're not disappointed. Ball's bouncing. Oh! Stop. Dropped at about the 38-yard line, it appears.
And the kickoff.
There was some chaos on that kickoff there. Ball bounced high over the first line of defense. Over the second line of defense. And then a little ping pong.
Start first and 10 from the 39-yard line.
1:53 to go, third quarter. 21-13 middies. Looks to be a false start on the Patriots. And it is.
It'll be a false start on the offense. It'll be a 5-yard penalty. And it will remain first down.
Push back by first and 15 from the 34 for the Patriots. Here at Beaudry Field on a crisp Saturday evening. Back to pass. Oh, he's going to be sacked by the middies.
And he is
That's right, number five, Devin Lambert. Drops it for a loss of
number
six
five,
on the play.
Devin Lambert.
Jack Estaday has to be aware of backside pressure. And just didn't appear to be on that play. Easy handoff to, looks to be Sam Randall.
Handoff up the middle. Stopped
nope,
after a short game.
On the carry on that one.
It will bring up third and long for Concord-Carlisle.
Ball in the 30 now. And a pass out to Sam Randall. He's going up the sidelines. Can a mini catch him? Yes, they cut him down outside the 40, maybe at the 38.
And knocked out of bounds.
Too hard to see some of these minis numbers on this crisp evening.
It'll be first and 10.
First and 10 from the 35.
From the 35-yard line.
15 seconds and counting in the third quarter. Clock is running. Will they get the play off? Does appear. We got motion left to right by Concord-Carlisle. And Randall again, he's upended. What a hit by the Meters.
Short gain on the play.
Number 49 on the tackle.
We will end the third quarter here at Beaudry.
Nope, that's 45, Alan French. Beautiful hit by French.
Your score after three quarters of play. Concord-Carlisle 13. Your Drake at Minis 21.
We're at the start of the third, fourth quarter here. 21-13 Middies. Concord-Carlisle is driving, however. Second and seven from the 32 here in quarter number four. We're waiting for the clock operator to put the time on the clock. Send both teams back to their huddles while they fix the clock here. 11 minutes to go.
Come on, defense!
In this non-league matchup.
Let's hold the boys!
Yesterday back. Takes the ball, hands it off. No, he does not. He hands it off to number two, Farquharson, who's tackled on the edge at about the 30. Gain of about three.
Taken down, shy in the first down. It'll bring up third down.
It'll be third and five from the 30. 10:45 and counting in the fourth quarter. Nope, they give him the 29. Make that a gain of four. Third and four from the 29. Yesterday under center, two back set. He's back to pass. He's thrown it. Oh, he short arms it.
Concord-Carlisle pass over the middle is incomplete.
Look to be to number 33, perhaps. No, that's number 13. Fourth and four. 29-yard line. 10-13 in the third, fourth quarter here. Oh, Yesterday trips. He releases the ball. Oh, nice catch there.
Concord-Carlisle pass to the right side. He's complete.
To number 13 again.
Complete to number 13, Trent Hoffman. Results of the play is a Concord-Carlisle first down. It'll be first and goal from the 9-yard line.
Ball's at the 9, gain of about 20. My apologies to Mike Poitras for getting my head in the way. First and goal from the 9. 9:46 and counting. And Randall is hit for a loss.
And he's taken down in the backfield.
Loss of five or six.
That'll bring up second down.
Tackle by number 18 and number 24 for the Middies. Nick Carter. Thanks from the stands. It's kind of hard to play with the wind. Ball back on the 13-yard line. Loss of four.
And a timeout is taken by the offense.
Timeout on the field. 21-13 Middies. 9:18 to go in the fourth quarter. In this critical game in MIAA football. once again, a win in this game means that the victor claims a spot in the MIAA Division II or Division IIA playoffs. Drake in 2A is 3-3 and seeded 8th. Concord-Carlisle seeded 7th in Division II North with a cluster of other teams. Win, they're in. Lose, they play in the consolation bracket. Second and goal from 13. Three back set this time. Yesterday under center takes the snap. Looks, he's back to pass to a wide open receiver.
Concord-Carlisle pass complete to number 34, Joe Courtney.
34 on the catch.
And it'll be third and goal.
Makes it to the five. Gain of about
from the 5 yard line.
8 on the play. Still, it's third and goal. It's score, go home. Yesterday gets the play from the sidelines, jogs in. And still more Patriots shuffle in and out from the sideline. And we have a timeout. 20-second timeout. Appears to be Concord-Carlisle calling.
The timeout is taken by the offense.
Derek Prack, the defensive captain for the Middies, comes over to the near sideline, gets some instruction from Coach Rivers. Jogs back into the huddle. Patriots lining up quickly, settling down. Estebay under center. Nope, toss, sweep. Barkwish is going to make the corner touchdown, Concord-Carlisle.
Concord-Carlisle runs to the left.
And he's going
to
do a little dance in the end zone.
And they are in for the touchdown.
Do they go for one? Do they go for two? That's the question. Looks like they're going for two. And the tie. One split wide right. Two backs in the backfield behind Estrade. He takes the snap. Tosses it. He's got a reverse. Oh, it's short. Short on the pass. Incomplete.
No good.
Minnie's retained the 20.
After the Concord-Carlisle
to 21
touchdown,
lead.
The score with 8 minutes and 23 seconds remaining in the fourth
correction,
quarter.
Correction, 21 to 19.
Concord-Carlisle 19, your Drake at Minnie's 21.
So with 8:23 to remain in the game, we have a 2-point ball game. Playoffs on the line for both teams. Will Concord-Carlisle onside kick and try to drive down Beaudry Field yet again? Meadies have a 5-4-2 alignment out there. Five on the front line, four in the backs. And he tries to squib it. Number 45 picks it up.
Big off return by the middies.
Alan French recovered that kick. Now we have a flag in the field, probably an unsportsmanlike conduct.
There's a
late hit on the middies, as there was a scrum on the field for the ball. And yes, an unsportsmanlike conduct, personal foul penalty called on the middies. Ball's on the 37. They'll be marching them back 15 to about the 22-yard line. Rivers has something to say to the officials.
Flagrant play was a personal foul against Tariqi. That'll back him up.
.8:15 to go in the game, 21-19 middies. Drake it back. Lavasa keeps the ball. Takes it from the 22 up to about the 25.
Picks up a couple yards on the play. That'll bring up second down.
Gain of about three, yes. For the middies. Lavasa takes the snap, hands it to Choate. Choate's up the middle for about one or two more yards to about the 27, maybe the, yeah, the 27-yard line. Make that two.
On the carry. Picks up a couple yards on the play. Bring up third down for the middies. Third and about five.
Lavasa waiting for the snap. High snap, gets it to Choate, going wide right. He gets the corner. Where is he going to be
David Choate on the carry.
37, 38, yard line, maybe the 40.
After a Drake it, first down.
Nice call by Drake it. Ball's at the 37-yard line. Looks like Choate again. He lowers his head, takes it out to about
the
45.
Nine on the play. It'll bring up second down.
Just outside the 45, not quite the 46. Gain of about 8.5.
Go,
6:17 to go in the game. 21-19 middies. It's to be timeout middies.
And the timeout is taken by the offense.
Thank you. Concord-Carlisle comes back to the middle of the field. Mini's offense talks to Rivers, comes back as well. Play called. Single bat set, Choate. Labasa in the shotgun. Hands it, oh, they followed a fumble.
Fumble snap, Labasa will cover. But a loss of yards on the play to bring up third down.
Loss of about four there. Third and six now. Labasa gets the call from Rivers, brings it to the huddle. Choke. Next to Labasa on his left. They roll out together. Standard play. Does he get the corner? He gets the corner. Horse collar tackle. Fails across the 50. What do they spot at the 47 of the Concord-Carlisle Patriots?
Is a drink it. First down.
Get about. Let's see. 9, 3, 12 yards on the carry. First and 10, ball on the 47 for the Middies. 5:05 to go in the game. 21-19 Middies, playoffs on the line. Labasa keeps the ball again, follows some blocking. Eschews one tackler, gets inside the 45 to about the 44.
Number 10, Michael Labasa on the keeper. Gain of about four on the play, it'll bring up second down and six. For the Middies.
Ball on the 43-yard line. Gain of four, second and six. Why pass when you can run? 4:29, 28, 27. Clock running. Middies running. Hands it off to Choate, short side left. Oh, nice block in the corner there. Thrown to the ground on the sideline. Official there, no call.
Number 31, David Choate on the carry. Stepped out of bounds, that'll bring up third down. Over the Middies.
Loss of apparently three on the play as they mark the ball back at the 44-yard line. No, no gain. Third and six from the 44. Labasa looks right, cuts back left, cuts inside the 45. 43-yard line, maybe gain of about one.
Labasa on the keeper up the middle. Stop shy of the first down. It'll bring up fourth down for the Middies.
Fourth and seven Middies. Did they go for it? Did they punt away and rely on their defense? 3:45 and counting in the fourth quarter. We have a small but boisterous crowd on the Concord-Carlisle sidelines. We got Drake calling timeout, it appears. Fourth and seven, 44 yards to go to touchdown.
By the offense.
2-point lead, 3:24 and counting.
Let's go, Drake!
Concord-Carlisle comes back on defense. Looks to be a punt. There is really nobody back to catch this punt, though, as they're going full block, and we got a pooch. It's down there. It's going to be inside the 10 to the 9, maybe the 8.
Michael Lavassa with the punt all the way down.
That's right, the 9-yard line. Nice punt by Lavasser. They came at him with a punt block. He handled it
from their own 9-yard line.
Rugby kicked it down the right-hand side. So with 3:15 to go, 21-19 minis, playoffs on the line. Concord-Carlisle with the ball and 91 yards to go. Long pass, he's got Farquharson. Uh-oh, no! Worst case scenario, he's racing down the sideline. Nobody's near him. It's going to be a touchdown for Concord-Carlisle.
And he runs in for the touchdown.
Concord-Carlisle. PAT on the way. Kick or two-point conversion, I don't know.
Two-point conversion is no good. But after the Concord-Carlisle touchdown, your score with 2 minutes and 59 seconds remaining in the fourth quarter. Concord-Carlisle 25, Drake it 21.
Do they kick away? Do they kick it into the wind and hope for the best? Squib kick picked up by the minis, going up the middle. Wrestling match at about the 26-yard line.
Kickoff return by number 31, David Choate. Taken down. And Drake it will start. First and 10.
2:53 to go in the game.
From the 32-yard line.
High snap, Lavasa keeps the ball, pitches it to Choate, who drops the ball. Concord-Carlisle falls on it at the 24-yard line.
Recovered by Concord-Carlisle. After Another fumble. It'll be Concord-Carlisle's ball. First and 10 from the 24-yard line.
2:46 to go in the game. Concord-Carlisle covers the fumble on a bad pitch by Lavasse to show. 2:46 remains in the game. Ball at the 24. They should run out the clock here. And Randall takes the handoff up the middle, stopped by a host of middies, but not before he gets to about the 21, maybe the 20.
Run by Concord-Carlisle, short gain in the play.
Timeout,
Drake taken by the defense. It'll be second and 6 for Concord-Carlisle.
Gain of 3, they're marking it at the 21. Second and 7 middies. Trailing 25-21. 2:38 remaining on the clock. Do they have a miracle in them? Yesterday under center, two-back set. Hands it off to Sam Randall again, where he's met at the line. Middies a fight for the ball.
Run up the middle and stopped at the line.
Tackle.
It'll bring up third down. And the timeout is taken by the defense.
Let's go! Ball marked down at the 20. They give a 1 on the play. So it will be 3rd and 6 from the 20. This midi defense is not giving up.
Hold the defense, hold them!
2:30 remaining in the fourth quarter, trailing by 4.
Defense!
Fans imploring the midi defense to come up with a stop and a turnover. As today goes, hands it off, Farquharson around the right, left edge, and he's tackled.
Run by Concord-Carlisle, stopped after a short gain. It'll bring up fourth down.
Come on, defense!
It will be fourth down. Question is fourth and how many?
By the defense.
A field goal, if they have it in them, from Concord-Carlisle would make it a 7-point lead, which the middies could certainly answer. Looks to be spotted about 1 yard gain, making it 4th and 5.
Here we go, Drayton! Here we go!
And they'll hand the ball off. Oh, Randall up the middle, looks to have the first down.
Run up the middle for Concord-Carlisle. And it's enough for a first down.
And it is, ball's at about the 12-yard line. Gain of 7 yards on the play. Middies trailing by 4, 2:01 and counting on the clock.
Let's go, Drake! Come on, Drake!
Flag. Delay of game by Concord-Carlisle.
Flag delay of game on the offense.
That'll be a 5-yard penalty.
That'll be a 5-yard penalty.
Watch play and go. Come on, defense! Let's go!
Get up, boys, let's go!
Let's go, defense!
Randall with the handoff up the middle. He might get to the 15, gain of about two.
Up the middle, taken down after a short gain. That'll bring up second down for Concord-Carlisle.
Still, the clock is running. Meadies have no timeouts left, I believe. 1:28 and counting on the clock. It'll be second and 13. Ball at the 15.
Let's go, defense!
Randall catches it on the edge. Oh, ankle tackle by...
Run by Concord-Carlisle to the right side.
The Meadies fails. He gets about two, maybe three. We'll see where they spot the ball. It's outside the 10, at about the, just inside the 13-yard line. Gain of about two, inside 1:30 to go. Patriots content to let the clock run down. We're inside 30 seconds. Do they even have to take another snap? Yes, they will. Third and 11, ball on the 13-yard line. They take a knee. And this game is over. Meadies lose a heartbreaker, 25-21. Playoffs hope appear to be dashed.
Audrey Field, your score.
What an incredible finish. But a sad finish for the Meadies. 21.